Welcome to the Lenten kickoff. Lent is an important season in our church. And for the last couple years, we've done a big kickoff event around it, not only for Lent, but also a time for fellowship, as we've included a chili cook-off as part of our time together. This year, of course, is different, but the season is still important. It still matters, maybe now more than ever. And so we're going to have a kickoff of sorts. We'll have some prayer, and we'll have some music. We'll have a little bit of a introduction to the season so that you can get the most out of this time, so that your heart is open and ready for what God wants to do in your life. So, welcome to this year's Lenten kickoff. Maybe warm up your own bowl of chili and join us. Let us pray. Loving and holy God, as we get ready to begin the season of Lent, we come with expectation. We look toward all that you will do in this time to draw us closer to you, to give us reason and purpose for life and for living. As we come into this season, we know and we trust that your love for us goes before us and makes a way. So awaken us, aliven us, and draw us to you. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Beautiful things out of dust. The work of Lent is personal and individual. As we spend that time in prayer and reflection and thinking about our own life and watching for how God wants to work in our life. But as the church, as the people of Christ, we are called to be in community. And so Lent also has this part that's done in community as we worship together, and most importantly, together in our small groups. If you are not already in a small group, we want to encourage you to give it a try. We've got several groups that are going to meet. They will start by meeting on Zoom. We will see what happens throughout the season. They'll meet for about an hour and a half once a week. And as part of each of those sessions, there will be a video teaching by the author, and I think you're really going to enjoy the videos. He's great to listen to. And then some Bible study and discussion. This is the book, and I want to assure you, because so many of us are so busy, but I want to assure you that you can do this reading. You don't have to be a Bible expert or a theologian to understand what he's trying to teach. It's the beauty of part of it. It really is for all of us to have a better understanding. One of the things about small groups that I want you to know is that they're diverse. We are all at a different place in our faith journey. In every small group that I've experienced, there is someone who will teach you, and there is someone who's waiting for you to teach them. So don't be hesitant about doing it if you don't think that you're ready, you've never been in a Bible study before. They're a great place to learn. They're a great place to connect with each other. They're a great place to be encouraged and to encourage those who are with you. These books are available wherever you get your books online, in paper book or as an ebook. And if you're not able to join a group at this time, that's okay. We understand. We encourage you to go ahead and get the book and do the reading on your own. Between that and the Sunday sermons, it will help you to experience God in a new way this season, we think. Many people give up something during the season of Lent, but I want you to think about maybe taking on the spiritual practice of daily reading and Bible study and prayer, and taking on the practice of being a part of a small group. It will grow your faith, I promise. We hope that you'll join us.
To be my child.
Lent is a powerful season. It is that time when we journey with Jesus to the cross and then to the glory that is Easter. Lent is often spoken of as 40 days, but that doesn't count Sundays. So if you count everything, it's about 46 days. It starts on Ash Wednesday, which is February 17th. And then it ends on Holy Saturday, the day before Easter. Traditionally, the season has a focus on repentance, but that's a harsh and difficult word for a lot of us. And so I think we oftentimes miss out on what Lent has for us because of that. One of the things that have helped me understand Lent better is to understand what repentance is in a little fuller sense. Jesus, who not only spoke Greek, but would have spoke some Aramaic and Hebrew, would have known the word for repentance in Hebrew is the word teshuvah. Teshuvah not only means to repent, but it has in it so much more this expectation of returning. So it's more than just turning from things, but turning toward God, returning to God. Returning to God, I think, is what Lent is all about. No matter how far we've wandered, no matter what's gone on in our life, this is a season of homecoming, of returning to God. This year, our focus is on the cross. We're looking at what the cross means. And the cross is, of course, a central piece of Christianity. It is the central symbol. But what does it mean? I think if you ask people what the meaning of the cross is, many times we'd struggle to explain it in its fullness. What does the cross do for us? And what does it mean historically and theologically and practically? Well, did you know that there are at least 6 different understandings of the cross? Yeah. The cross doesn't mean just one thing. What Jesus did for us, what God did for us through Jesus, has many ways of understanding it. So this Lent, we have something very special for you. We have a wonderful book that we're going to focus on during the season, Savior by Magrey, deVega, and it has the 6 meanings of the cross that we'll be talking about and learning together. I'm excited for you to hear and to learn all about this. So let's pause and hear from the author.
Have you ever found yourself asking what the cross of the Christian faith really means? Or what exactly did Jesus do on the cross, and why was it necessary? And what does it mean for us today? Hi, I'm Magrey deVega, author of Savior, What the Bible Says About the Cross. In my new book and Bible study experience, we're going to examine these questions by considering how the Bible describes Jesus' death and how it brings reconciliation between sinful humankind and a holy God. No single image or metaphor fully captures the meaning of Jesus' death and resurrection. The Bible uses several metaphors, each illuminating a different facet of how the cross brings salvation. Each week, we will explore the pros and the cons of these images while developing a greater awareness of our own sin and an appreciation to God's faithful love. But you know what? Studying these biblical ways of speaking about Jesus' death ought to be more than just an intellectual thought exercise. It should also deepen our love for God and other people, and it should also strengthen our commitment to follow Jesus. For those reading the book with others, we've created a 6-week Bible study experience specifically for the season of Lent that includes a leader guide and a DVD with video sessions for each week. Through this study, my hope is that your understanding of the cross may be deepened, that your behavior shaped by the power of the Holy Spirit, and that your commitment to Christ might be strengthened. Ultimately, my prayer is that you will be inspired by God's love for you, revealed by the work of Jesus Christ on the cross.
So, how do we receive what God has for us this Lent? Well, I think we receive it by participating in the season. I want to give you some ideas on how you can take your place in this life-changing, powerful, ancient story and find that this Lent, there's a big message for you. So here's what I encourage you to do. First, be with us as we do our Lenten first experience, which is Ash Wednesday. That happens on 2/17, and it's a walk-through experience. During the time when you're here, you will experience a station where you learn more about Lent, where you get a chance to leave behind something you don't want to take into the Lenten season, a time to receive ashes and light candles, and to hear powerful music to move you into the season. We're really excited for this walk-through event, and we invite you to register for it. Now, one of the things that's really great is that at the end of our walk-through experiences, we have this Lent in a bag. You'll get to take home with you some different tokens that will help you create a focal point in your home for the season. You'll receive a cross, some sand to remind you of Jesus and his temptations, a candle holder that will invite you to decorate and return for Holy Thursday, and a devotional booklet. We'd love for you to register and be part. We'll be practicing social distancing and wearing masks, and you'll see how to sign up on your screen. I also want to invite you to what we're going to do at the very end of Lent. So, a Holy Week, which is the week before Easter, the end of the season of Lent, we're going to have the Stations of the Cross. Well, we're calling them the Journey to the Cross because they're not the Roman Catholic stations. They're a Protestant group of stations and reflections that will help us journey with Jesus from the beginning to the end, from the start of his journey to the cross to his crucifixion and being laid in the tomb. We have some beautiful art that will be part of this, large art. Each of the paintings is 6 feet tall, and they'll be throughout our campus, and you'll have a chance to read devotions that Pastor Michelle and I will write, hear some music, and journey around and have an experience of journeying with Jesus to the cross. You'll be hearing more about this over the season of Lent. Michelle has told you about the book that we're looking at and invited you to small groups. And I just want to really affirm the importance of that. Sometimes we think, I'm zoomed out. Don't worry about it. You can drop into these groups and find a real opportunity to get to know people and to deepen your faith. I invite you on this journey in the season of Lent. Join us for Ash Wednesday. Join us for small groups and to read the book. And join us for Holy Week. Who knows? You may find, like the prodigal, that God has been waiting for you to come home all along. Join with me in this video prayer. This is a prayer from St. Ephren. It's called the Lenten Prayer. It was written in the 4th century, and it has been contemporized a bit. But join me in this visual prayer as we journey to Lent together.
Still.